Bonjour, bonjour, fragrance lover. Welcome back to my...
Hey, what do you want to hear about Tommy Ford?
So before you watch the video, please subscribe to my channel and also leave a little comment to tell me what you think about it, if you like the video and blah blah blah, whatever. And follow me on Instagram to see a bit more of what... to see a bit more of me. So in today's video, I took like two new launches, which is Tom Ford Rose Brick and Jo Malone Vetiver and Golden Vanilla. I wanted to review them separately, and then I thought, you know what, it's two launches, let's compare them together, and then we're gonna learn about it like this. And also this scent, like, have like this kind of like incense-y, mysterious type of vibe, so I was like, let's put them together. So to do this little battle, we're gonna have little point, little marks for each of them. So I separate the review in few categories, and we're gonna judge them on each category and see who is winning. Start off with the first category, which is about the name, the design, like the introduction basically of the fragrances. Tom Ford Rose Brick, so it's one of the private blends, and I thought like the name was really cool. Of course, like very shocking, very like very Tom Ford, really want to shock a little bit. And you're gonna see after that the name is really related to also the description, which I think the composition, so I think it's quite cool. And also the bottle, I mean, I love it so much. I already love the private blend bottle. I think they're so elegant, classic, you have nothing to say about it. This one is like dusty pink, like a baby pink color, which is definitely my favorite color. So I'm like, oh, it's so pretty, and it looks matte. It's so soft when you touch it. Such a beautiful bottle. And it's quite risky for Tom Ford because it's a unisex scent, and you might think that it's for ladies, but no. But yeah, beautiful. And then you have the Jo Malone one, which is part of the Cologne Intense as well. So one of the these are basically the stronger scent of Jo Malone. They're usually a bit more intense, in depth, woody notes, which is my favorite family of fragrance in Jo Malone. But the bottle is the same as the Cologne Intense, so the black one, very elegant, very beautiful, looks like a little bit like tea. I love that design. But yeah, it doesn't bring anything different for this one. That's why my mark and my point goes to Tom Ford, because, you know, for the creativity. And then the second category will be the composition. So we're really purely gonna talk about the ingredient. So for Tom Ford Rose Brick, we are really in like a rosy scent. So you've got turmeric, citron paper, and the citron paper is what I smell the most, really, for me. You've got Turkish rose, May rose, and Bulgarian rose. So it's really like a bouquet of roses. And then you've got tonkebin and patchouli and the dry down. I thought there was wood in the composition of myself, because when it dried down, it smelled, it's very woody, not really like a rosewood scent as we know this popular olfactive family. Yeah, for me, it really smelled like a typical rosewood scent, even though it's apparently no wood. So it's a really different type of roses, different from the Noir des Noirs that Tom Ford like gave us before, or the Café Rose that Tom Ford gave us as well. This one is more like spicy roses, I would say. It's basically after a few minutes, you have the prick that is appearing, which is, I think, the citron paper that make it like slightly like spicy, and it's really what I feel. But at the beginning, you've got an opening that is very strong in the rose. That's what I had. I had a burst of all the roses, which all the bouquet exploded in my face. But with the time, the dry down, you have more the pepper, which I think is bringing a nice touch to the fragrance. And also, you can really, for me, like smell the patchouli at the end. When after a few hours, this is really what I could smell the most on my skin. And what I appreciate is that it's not a patchouli that is very earthy and grassy. It's more a patchouli that smells a bit more rounding, nearly sticky, a bit honeyed. It's really the type of patchouli that you had in vintage fragrances, which I really enjoy that touch, and I think it gives like a quite like a nice creativity to the fragrance, and also it makes it stays really long. The dry down is also a bit vanilla-like. That's the tone cabin that gives a bit of warmth to the fragrance. I feel the fragrance is encapsulated with slightly an incense-y type of scent that is really common for the fragrances from Tom Ford. It gives him a bit like of, I don't know, mysterious attraction. Eh, Merlin?
Enough is enough. Arrête.
Ouh là là. But overall, when I smell all this composition and this fragrance, it's something that I've seen before and that I experienced before. The scent is beautiful, don't get me wrong, I really love it. But it's just something that I smelled before. Even though I really like the touch of pepper inside, I think it makes really the difference. But, yeah. Then we have Jo Malone composition of fragrance. We go for something much more simple for Jo Malone. As usual, simplicity, but something that smells very elaborated at the end. So you have cardamom, grapefruit, tea, vetiver, and vanilla, of course. So I was scared when I smelled it, because when I've seen vanilla, it's always like scaring me, even though I really like oriental. But this one is a vanilla that is not sweet, which I really enjoy. And why that is because the vetiver is so earthy that it really balances the vanilla. It makes it a bit more softer, greener, and I think it makes a perfect balance with it. And I rarely see a lot of vanilla with such a green ingredient that much, so it's really interesting actually. It smells very smoky, very incense-like. And for example, if you try Meron Tonka before for Jo Malone, basically this one for me is like a little sister, well, on the same level, I'm a little sister of this fragrance. It really smells alike, but in a different way. It's like another interpretation of it, really, with two different ingredients. But like the spirit of this mysterious vibe and incense vibe is there. I really like also the fact that the cardamom feels like cooling down the fragrance. What's wrong, baby? What's wrong? And yeah, it really cools down the fragrance, so it killing a bit the vibe of too much sweetness and cool it down, which I think is really well done. Also, I can't smell the grapefruit, so I don't know, like, if you tried it, tell me if you smelled it, because I can't smell it. But I thought the ingredients were really interesting together, and it really is very unusual to see all this greenness with the vanilla. Also, for me, the tea notes really smells like nearly like a medicine-like, or a little bit like something, I don't know, very soothing, which sounds bad when you say medicine, but for me, it makes me really relax, and I did really enjoy that. So for me, in terms of ingredient composition, what we didn't see before, and something quite innovative, I will go for the Jo Malone. I think it's a simplistic composition, but I like the fact that the ingredient, I don't often see them together. And yeah, I just really enjoyed that, I don't know, like slightly Asian type of feeling with that tea accord. So then the other category I wanted to talk about is the inspiration and how the fragrance makes you feel. For who is that for? Who's gonna wear that? Things like that. So, for Tom Ford, it really is a loud scent for me. Like, it's really Tom Ford DNA. It feels smoky, churchy, this type of vibe. It's really like a provocative spiciness as well. So it's quite loud for me when you wear it. It's also like, I feel the prick makes it very rock and roll as well. So for someone with a lot of character that want to basically not show off, but you know, for example, for me, I'm not really like a rose type of person, but with a little bit of a prick, I mean, I think it's quite nice. So for a lady that's got that that touch, that extravagant type of touch, but don't want a very romantic roses. I think it's so nice. Also, it gave me really like a vintage touch, like I said again, with the patchouli. It really smells like a dark bouquet of red roses, you know, that type of feeling. It's not the usual romantic roses, it's something a bit more deep, really, like the roses with the, you know, the all the thingies. It, do you know what, like if I would compare it to a celebrity, I would say it's Eva Green, this fragrance, you know, like a bit gothic, dark, rock and roll, but very elegant lady. That's, for me, that's, it makes me think of that. And then for Jo Malone, it's something very addictive, attractive fragrance. It's something that I couldn't stop like smelling my wrist when I'm wearing it. It's very addictive, but it makes me think of more like an exotic kind of attraction. Like I say, like it makes me think of really something very Asian. It's look at him. Look at him. What's wrong, baby? You don't want me to talk today, huh? All right. It feels really cocooning, and also, so I'm gonna change country a little bit, but when I wore it, it was extremely cold, and I really felt that I could be in a very cold country, like for example Canada, where it's a bit like snowing, or I would imagine myself in a chalet with the cheminée, and you know, having a hot chocolate or something like that. And yeah, it feels really like cozy, cocooning, soothing kind of feeling. And also it was like such an elegant scent as well, without being too sweet. So see, if you're afraid of sweetness, really, like this is quite a nice approach. Also for me, like it's really for the vetiver lover, because you'll be quite happy that for once we don't see a vetiver very grassy, greener, lighter. Look at this. Oh, baby. Right, you're gonna have a view on Merlin. Ah, Merlin. Ah, Merlin. Mon gros Merlin. I'm sorry, it's like my kids, literally. Alright, so coming back to vetiver. And also, I thought the composition was very charming. And I would definitely see on a gentleman as well. I think that would look very charismatic, but at the same time, comforting. It's, what's wrong with this light? I thought, like, for a man, like, it would be, like, I don't know. I would feel secure with a scent like this. For this category, it's quite tricky. I'm probably gonna judge it by the fact that, does it bring something really to the brand itself? Is it something that we didn't see before for another type of personality? Things like that, you know. I think the Tom Ford will satisfy a lot of person, like will attract a new public, and probably is something like quite different in terms of personality or fragrance. The Jo Malone is really like for the one that really enjoyed the Mia and Tonka before. I feel for me it's quite the same vibe. So I think for that I will give my point to Tom Ford. Yeah, I would. It's so difficult, to be honest. I love the scents. But yeah, I will give it to Tom Ford. Let's go for the other one. And finally, the last category, and it's the category that really, for me, doesn't mean that much a lot, because it's the longevity and performance. Just because, like, for me, when I really enjoy the scent, the performance is not that important for me, but I know it is for a lot of people. But when I love the juice, I can deal with the performance and try to find some tips and tricks to make it stay more longer. But yeah, anyway, so as a bonus, I will add it to it. And anyway, we have two because they are exactly at the same level at the moment, so I can't make any decision. I've wore the two quite a long time, for a whole day together, a few times. And so the Tom Ford stayed really well. At the end, I can really feel a really powdery note. After like 4 to 6 hours, I could smell a lot of powder, a bit more delicate, and still a bit of patchouli as well. So it went a bit discreet, maybe 4 to 5 hours, very discreet, powdery kind of feeling. So like, you know, this type of time. For the Jo Malone, I have to say it didn't move at all on my skin. At all. I wore it during around the same time as Tom Ford, and even after 5 hours or something like that, I was smelling it on my wrist and it wouldn't have moved. So I was really impressed by the longevity, and I mean, if it's something that means for you, I think you won't be disappointed with this one. Because for me, at least on my skin, it stayed really long, really, really long. Like, so for that, I think I have to give my point to Jo Malone for this one. So overall, we have 2 points. 2 points, do we? I've got 2 marks, 2 points for Tom Ford and 3 for Jo Malone. So it's Jo Malone that is winning. But to conclude my video, I'm going to tell you that I enjoyed so much those two fragrances. It's such a good release from the two brands. And again, my points are very subjective, so you might prefer one or the other. But for me, the two are really nice and I was pleasantly surprised when I tried them. The only thing that, voilà, that maybe... Am I gonna buy them? I'm definitely buying the Jo Malone, that's for sure. For the Rose Prick, I have a lot of things to buy before, and I'm not very a rosy person, and sometimes it can bother me a little bit. So I'm not too sure about it again, but I thought it was like a nice addition if I wanted a nice rose scent, because I don't have a lot, because I'm usually like not really attracted to rosy scent, but I thought it was really original composition, so I might do that, actually, I might get it. But yeah, so that's it for me today. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please tell me in the comments which team are you. Are you Jo Malone or are you Tom Ford? If I were like on a general basis, I would always go Tom Ford. It's like my favorite. I love Tom Ford fragrance, really, I love them. So, but yeah, for this fragrance, I'm going Jo Malone. So tell me what you think, tell me which one is your favorite for the two fragrances, if you like the brands as well, and I will see you soon. Bye now.